Hello, welcome back to Learn Economia. In this video, we are going to look into the linear regression and its properties. What is linear regression? Linear regression strives to show the relationship between two variables by applying a linear equation to observed data. One variable is supposed to be an independent variable and the other one is a dependent variable. For example, the weight of a person is linearly dependent to not dependent, but it is related to that person's height. Hence, this shows a linear relationship between the height as well as weight of a particular person. As the height increased, what happens is that the weight is also supposed to get increased. It is not necessary that one variable is dependent on others or one causes the other, but there is some kind of critical relationship exists between the two variables. In these kinds of cases, we have to use the scattered plot to imply the strength of this kind of relationship. If there is no relation or linking between the variables, then the scattered plot does not indicate any kind of increasing or decreasing pattern. For such cases, we can see that the linear regression design is not beneficial to a given data. Linear regression equation. This is very much important. The measure of the extent of the relationship between the two variables is shown by the correlation coefficient. The range of this coefficient lies between minus 1 and plus 1, right? And this coefficient shows the strength of the association of the observed data for the two variables. A linear regression line equation is written in the form of y equal to a plus bx, where x is the independent variable and plotted along the x-axis. Y is the dependent variable, which is plotted along the y-axis, and the slope of the line B and A is the intercept. Okay, the value of y when x is equal to 0. That is a kind of assumption that we have to take into consideration. Linear regression formula. The linear regression shows the relationship between two variables that we have already discussed. The equation of linear regression is similar to the slope formula that we have learned before in earlier classes and all, such as the linear equations in the two variables. Okay, and this is given by y is equal to a plus bx. Now, here we need to find the value of the slope of the line b plotted in the scattered plot and the intercept a. A is equal to sigma y into sigma x squared minus sigma x into sigma xy divided by n into sigma x square minus sigma x the whole square. Okay, and b is equal to n into sigma xy minus sigma x into sigma y divided by n into sigma x square minus sigma x square. Okay, simple linear regression. The very most straightforward case of a single scalar predictor variable x and a single scalar response variable y is known as a simple linear regression. The equation of this regression is represented by y is equal to a plus bx. The expansion to multiple as well as vector value predictor variables is known as a multiple linear regression, which is also known as the multivariable regression or multivariable linear regression. The equation of this regression is represented by y is equal to a plus bx. You could see that we have been giving the equations or similar equations, right? Almost in the real world, regression patterns include the multiple predictors, and the basic explanation of linear regression are often explained in terms of the multiple regression form. Because in reality, we know that if there is a particular effect and this effect is not caused by any single cause, there could be a set of factors which affect the effect, or there could be a set of factors which influence or cause the effect. So as we have already seen, we have to look into the simple variable regression equation as well, as we have already discussed in the case of scatter plot. So all these things are very much important. So what is a least square regression line or linear regression line? This is very important as far as linear regression or least square regression is concerned. The most popular method to fit a regression line in the xy plot is a method of least square. This process would determine the best fitting line for the knotted data by reducing the sum of squares of the vertical deviation from each data point to the line. If point rests on the fitter line accurately, then its perpendicular deviation is zero because the variations are first squared, then added. Their positive as well as negative values would not be considered. So here we can see how it is plotted, how these variables are related. Linear regression determines a line which is known as the least square regression line or LSRL. The best expresses observations in bivariate analysis of data sets. Suppose y is a dependent variable and x is the independent variable, then the population regression line is given by y is equal to v0 plus v1x, where v0 is a constant and v1 is the regression coefficient. If a random sample of observation is given, then the regression line is expressed by y hat equal to b0 plus b1x, where b0 is constant, b1x is a regression coefficient, x is an independent variable, and y hat is a predicted value of the dependent variable. What are the properties of linear regression? For the regression line, where regression parameters b0 and b1 are defined, the properties are given by the line reduces sum of the square differences between the observed values as well as the predicted values. The regression line passes through the mean of x and y variable values. And the regression constant b0 is equal to y intercept, the linear regression. And the final thing is the regression coefficient b1 is the slope of the line, which is equal to the average change in the dependent variable y for a unit change in the independent variable x. Coming to the regression coefficient, in the linear regression line, we have seen in the equation which is y is equal to b0, b1x. Here b0 is constant, b1 is the regression coefficient. Now let's come to the formula to find out the value of the regression coefficient. B1 is equal to capital B1 is equal to small b1 is equal to sigma xi minus x into yi minus x divided by sigma xi minus x square, where xi and yi are the observed data sets and x and y are the mean value. So that's all. I hope you could get at least some kind of understanding regarding the least square. So that's all. I'll be back with another video on the same topic when we have to add the case of error term. So we have to understand how we could add error terms and all. For example, let's tell you something. For example, if you are taking into consideration a kind of cost-effect relationship, this is something which we take into consideration, especially in the case of regression and all. In the regression, we look into the cost-effect relationship, right? So in this case, we have a particular cause, we have a particular effect, and this effect is influenced by a set of factors. So just consider that you are taking into consideration n number of factors you are taking into consideration, or you are putting into your regression model. But that does not mean that you are taking into consideration all the values. You might be excluding unknowingly or accidentally or not deliberately. You might be excluding some values, okay, or some factors you are excluding. So these are certain factors, these excluded factors are set, these two are also certain factors which would be influencing the effect. So in order to incorporate into the consideration the factors or the excluded factors in the model, what you do is that you will include a term known as the error term. Okay, so in the next video we'll be discussing we will be having some discussion related to the error term. Either in the next video or in the coming videos we'll be discussing that, because discussing error term is very important as far as regression is concerned. Okay, so with that we have to end right now. With respect to this video, we have to end right now. So I request you to like, share, and subscribe to this channel for more videos, and I welcome you to my Telegram group as well as Telegram channel to discuss your doubts. I am really happy to say that there have been many people who are benefiting a lot out of their discussions, doubt clarification, etc. by being a part of this Telegram channel as well as Telegram group. I'll be providing the links of the same in the description box so that you will be able to join, and you'll also be able to benefit out of it. So please make it please just note that we have not considered error term in this video, but we'll be definitely considering the role of error term in order to look in more into the regression aspect, especially this Blue theorem and all we'll be looking into. So Blue theorem is actually a very important concept or very important topic that we have to look into. We'll be definitely doing a video on that. So that's all. Thank you.